Happy birthday, DJ Blaze. Turn up. Happy birthday, DJ Blaze.
Yo, you know what's up? This is DJ Blaze hanging on my man Super Mario. You know what it is, man. Each and every Monday right here at Red Lobster, we do the open mic. My man, Brother Earl, we just had some funny here tonight. And you know, I'm in here every once in a while, so come check me. Come check everybody else that's in here. My man, big shout out to my man, Brother Earl. Big shout out to DJ Mario. You can catch me at DJBlade24 at Instagram.com. That's probably the best way to catch me on Instagram. Facebook, Instagram is a lot better. But you know what it is, man. You know, happy holidays to everybody. And congratulations to all the Sagittarians out there. You know what I'm saying? Happy birthday. Peace out.
Hey, DJ Blade. Happy birthday to you. Happy 21st. Twice over, minus one. So you finally made it. So I wish you the best. I wish you much love. I remember you on the block, 140th Street with your dad. I know he's smiling down on you, that you continue his legacy, DJing, and you're doing a great job traveling, and you're making everybody happy with your music. So you keep it up, you keep living, and keep loving. Happy birthday.
Hey, how you doing tonight? Shout outs to my man, Brother Earl, and Freedom of Speech, DJ Mario. Behind the lights and camera action shit going on. This life. Rocking the stage tonight with a little healing. Love you. Every Monday, that's what we do. All right? Peace.
Wow. New York City, Connecticut, Philadelphia, Baltimore. Everybody out there who has network, internet, Facebook, MySpace. MySpace. Wow. Remember MySpace? Anyway, what brings me out tonight is DJ Blade. You and I go back when we didn't even have cell phones. So I just want to wish you the best with your birthday. Wishing you many, many more. I had to come through. I had to stop by Mocha Lounge and come over here because Smokey's celebrating his birthday. You're celebrating your birthday. And a lot of people are celebrating life in general. And a shout out going out to all those who are watching this video, because with all the videos out here, you really don't have to watch this. So if you're watching this, thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. In a few minutes, we're going to interview Claudette St. Rose. She's usually here hosting the show, which is called Believe in Yourself Video. So we're going to get a couple of words from her, and then we're going to get some interviews from people who came through for DJ Blade, those who came through for open mic, and most importantly, came out to support Brother Earl. He's the host here every Monday night, so you can find him on Earl Majette, Earl Majette, or man, that's how you look at it, Earl Majette on Facebook, and tell him what you heard about it on DJ Mario TV. If you need me for future events or whatever it may be, weddings, birthday parties, and even baby showers, hit me up, 646-206-8859. As I say in all my videos, don't take my word for it. We'll be right back with more after these messages. Peace.
Give it up for Ivy, y'all. Okay.
I call this stage my life. Portrait.
Yeah.
Yeah. Real quick, we support a brother. Forgot that you heard, I do have on DVD. 16 live performances and some time of open clarity. Please do support. For those of y'all on Instagram, hit brother up and get some more followers. DBlackBX on Instagram. Love y'all. Happy holidays. I'll see y'all next week.
Wow, D Black. Yeah. Now, he did a piece on smoking. I think I'm going to try. I'm going to try to do this.
How's everybody doing out there? This is David Roberts, a.k.a. D Black, here at the wonderful Red Lobster on 125th Street, doing our open mic that we do for Brother Earl. If y'all not here, y'all missed it. Happy holidays from me to you and yours. D Black, a.k.a. David Roberts, and I'm out.
Yes, you pass the mic, This is Locke Smith, L-O-X-S-M-Y-T-H. I'm wishing happy holidays for each and every one of you. We out here, freedom of speech, open mic, beautiful, lovely collaboration of poets and singers and rappers and love and energy. All right, so y'all can come out, do your thing, be part of this, and happy holidays once again. Locke Smith, L-O-X-S-M-Y-T-H.
This is Frank the Cameraman wishing you a happy birthday from Frank the Cameraman and DJ Mario TV.
Yo, man, look, that's the next beautiful thing about an open mic. We are all here on different levels. Some people is wily veterans, some people are just starting, you know, and it's all good, okay? Because this is the environment for you to grow as an artist, okay? Or stay sharp, all right? That's what open mics do, all right? So it's all right. You know, you're going to grow in here, man, because I'm going to see to that, all right? But before we continue on, it's about time that I do have a word from our sponsor, okay? There's a word from our sponsor, and I just, you know, it's important that all of us, you know, see this specific ad for our sponsor, and it goes a little something like this.
If you want this venue to go far, buy some food, support the bar.
Yes, my brother, we are here through a collaboration with Red Lobster, okay? And we as artists in the community, we should support the establishments that support us in our artistic endeavors, okay? What I ask is, hey, if you're hungry, get you something to eat, okay? Get you something to eat, all right? If you're thirsty, get you something to drink, okay? And if you're not thirsty, buy me a drink, okay? Or better yet, buy one of these fine young ladies a drink, okay? Who taught you, okay? Where'd you learn the game at? You see these beautiful sisters clearing their throat, dummy? Okay, something, okay? That's all it is, man. Please support the establishment so we can continue doing what we're doing. This is a beautiful vibe, and I'm glad to be the host or just, you know, steering this train, but that's what it is. Now, moving right along, I'm getting ready to call up a good friend of mine, man. We met in this poetry exactly 16 years ago, damn near to the exact time, okay? There used to be a poetry event at Jimmy's Uptown on 132nd and 7th Avenue, okay? 131st and 7th Avenue. And this brother rolled in there, not sure what this was about, but he just figured, yo, I do poetry and I'm here to get this money. Okay, and somehow, man, we started up a conversation. I think, you know, he saw something in the amulet and it led to a discussion. Long story short, over these 16 years, man, we have been friends on and off stage. So for our 16th anniversary, he comes in and out. You know, he's like Ali. He retires, unretires, doing vanilla. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for Problem Child. Yeah, Problem Child in the building. Here we go.
Turn it up a little bit.
Oh, beautiful, for spacious skies, for amber waves of grain, for purple mountain majesty above the fruited plains. America, America, God shed his grace on thee and crown thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea. As I walk through the streets of NYC, I realize there's only a few things a black man like me can get for free besides flyers and garbage and poetry. So I decided to do a street recital at the side of the curb, hoping that the people that passed by would not be disturbed by the shocking and provocative things that I had to say. And off the top of my head, here's what I said of that day.
As I walk past the garden, I'm not concerned with Bin Laden, even though a war might be starting, which some people are saying is jihad. Niggas versus the police might as well be on the undercard, the result of 200 years of disregard as they continue to violate the civil rights of anyone whose color is other than white. Now, how can a racial profile justify a routine traffic stop? Four young brothers just enjoying each other represent wreck for four cops, and then it was guess who stands and gets shot. As I stand beside the curb and observe, I say to myself, these pigs have the nerve to complain when every once in a while one of them gets what they deserve. When one goes down and regret that he caught one in the chest because he left his bulletproof vest in his vest and gets bad reviews in the news, but how soon they forget about Eleanor Bunkus and Patrick Dorsman and Amadou Diallo and Sean Bell and countless other innocent people. And every 6 months, they return with a sequel. These police ethics and morals are sleazy as peep shows, but evidence suppressed where? Only God knows. Too many times the cops get to walk in the wake of another victim outlined in chalk, and all our leaders ever seem to do is just talk. Well, wouldn't it be fun if we all brought guns to the next march on Washington and they could count the millions of caps launched at the Million Man Gap March, because the first march in D.C. was completely a farce. In fact, it doesn't have to stop there. It can hit other cities like a National Gap Rap Tour in the memories of Biggie and Tupac Shakur. And NYC could be advertised as everyone in free. You think September 11th was bad? This is something you never want to see. Read all about it. A million Negroes formerly considered zeros instantly become heroes where, boom, pop goes the racist. See all the thousands of petrified faces as the Million Gap March suddenly replaces what used to be tyranny and misrepresentation, but now it's expirations, but now explanations and retribution instead of reparations at the Million Gap March. It can go on and on like a marathon. Those who don't march can stay on the sidelines and cheer us on as we pass by hand us extra clips and sandwiches while Bush and his cabinet wonder what kind of shit is this as we show no regard for the National Guard and even the Ku Klux Klan ran like Taliban back to the cage that it never should have left in the first place. But the black man was originally the first race, and when we see you, you get in the gas face. And if you ain't fast when you pass, you just might get your ass laced as we continue to pick up the pace of the Million Gap March. The Prophet Jamal Muhammad set the tone when he said to leave stressed out brothers alone, cause either heaven, hell, or home from the Million Gap March. To the left, to the left, to the left, right, left. I have a dream that one day all black people will unite and rise up together and fire upon our oppressors, because as long as we allow them to continue to see us as lessons, things will never get any better. No justice, no peace, just pieces, feces. Kaleidoscope images of the initial skirmishes of the Third World War in my mind's eye. A full moon illuminates the playing field as fighter jets can set to take to the sky. High tech technology in technicolor as lasers, missiles, and rocket shots snap, crackle, and pop right before our eyes. The revolution will not be televised. Well, this one won't need to be, because we will hold these truths to be self-evident. Evident from cities, especially New York, as we look straight up, heads tilted slightly to the northwest, distressed as enemy fighter jets outnumber American F-16, 6-1, rotating and spiraling in tight formations for bombing runs. But this isn't a video game, it's war. It'll be evident from the farms in the mid-American states as missile silos mysteriously appear in cornfields, awaiting orders from Washington as we contemplate whether or not to escalate, because finally, it's time to put up or shut up, which is what happens when you push up on the weak long enough. Are the sins of the father finally to be paid for by the sons? And for the black man in America, there's no place to run as we're reduced to ignorant bystander status says crash reparations, the great thoughts of self-preservation, and early evening cookout turning to blackout so our homes can be protected. An attack on our homeland wasn't initially projected, but the calculator used to measure carbon must have been permanently defective. And finally, all the varying ideologies of the world around the same page as they all proclaim, we made it to happen this! The first series of incoming silos just barely missed amidst frenzied and frenetic fighting, and the price of these rocket launches could feed and in the village or renovate the projects. But instead of humanitarianism, we choose to build rockets, and there's no way to know how much dough is going into politicians' pockets. And I wrote this poem because of a dream I had last night, one that warns America that in spite of her delusions of might, she can't afford to underestimate the strength, the will, or the resolve of another country in a fight when they think they're right, and as guns begin unloading and bombs begin exploding, a voice comes on the radio and the man says, this is not a test, this is not a test, this is not a test, I repeat, this is And the black man will still be among the least of this country's problems because we watch TV shows reading the country all the way we think, and we pray to the same Jesus as his beast as he does, except we're better at it. And we join the same political parties he does, depending upon the size of the crumb he's pushing up his table for us, or we're totally disenfranchised altogether, not only homes, the right to vote, or a gun. And we listen to ridiculous rap lyrics that encourage us to do all we can do to bling bling, be seen but not heard, and politically not felt. Or we write poetry in an underground society that allows us to be heard but not seen, and sometimes I think the only ones that are feeling us are us. And we play sports which allows us to be seen but not heard. By the way, whatever happened to sports as a means to an education? Refer to rap lyric number 11205463A. Cash rules everything around me, and the rest of us do our best to pretend that we're not even black. And I'm gonna pause while you contemplate that. Gonna leave anyone out? Good. There's got to be a movement for us to join somewhere. And since when is war bad for this nation's economy? And whatever happened to the prophet of the national obvious who wrote the poem we've been had? What was his name? Problem Child. Okay, I'm not gonna, dominate the mic. Yeah, I'll pass it back. All right. Thank you, everybody. Problem Child in the building.
That's right, Kato the cameraman. That's right, we're here. You wasn't here, you missed it. Trust and believe. Spoken word. We had a ball, man. Supporting my brother, celebrating his birthday. DJ Blade, we rock. DJ Mario, you know I love you, my brother. Kato the cameraman, 347-408-9841. Or you can catch me on Facebook. Kato cameraman Bogan. And I'm out. Peace.
Hi, I am Claudette Smith.
Where are you?
I am a poet, and I am at Red Lobster, 125th in Harlem. And you can find me on Instagram, VIR_TRUE. That is VIR_TRUE, or Facebook, Claudette Smith. Happy holidays.
Okay. Tonight was open mic night at the Red Lobster on 125th Street.
Merry Christmas, DJ Mario TV.
For I am happy. There are people who enjoy their lives after marriage, after a child, after it all. All hail Mary Jane. Thank you, guys.
Yeah. Hey, New York, New York. Y'all ought to come down sometime on these Mondays.
Flashback. She had a Soul Train dancer flashback right there, yo. She was doing her thing.
Happy holidays, everybody. Merry Christmas. Shout out to Freedom Speech. Freedom. Oh my God. Open mic.
Why do we say goodbye? The same place twice, you and I.
I remember in high school, I used to take down the notes my teacher wrote on the board and no one else will.
Purple Mountain Majesty above the fruited plains.
You missed it. Trust and believe. Spoken word. We had a ball, man.
This is me, Tati. Miss Lip Gloss, as you call me. I'm here tonight at the open mic, at the BBQ's open mic. Okay, I did a little number a little earlier, did a little something. And I want to give a big shout out to Brother Earl, because without him, it'd be no this. So you people, come on down here on Mondays, okay? It starts at 8 o'clock. Showtime, 8 o'clock. Get in here, register. Get up in here. Show me what you got.
And it's free.
And show me what you got. I'll be waiting for you, all right? Stop me here at Red Lobster on Mondays, okay? 125th Street. Meet me in person.
Like 1987.
Okay.
Like 1987.
Right? Meet me in person.
Meet me in person.
Show me what you got. Good night.
Happy holidays from DJ Mario TV.
How y'all doing, everybody? This is Craig Allen from How You Living Radio. Coming to check out Brother Earl's event, open mic night at Red Lobster, 125th Street. Definitely looking forward to seeing the talent. There's a lot of artists out here. I have some of my artists out here from Ace Artist Management, Tierra Jean, Abstract, Nate the Great. So we definitely, TSB, the South Bronx, a lot of heads up in here. So we definitely trying to have a good time. You know, you guys should come check it out every Monday.
Peace. D-Cross the artist up here. Freedom of expressions, freedom of speech up here. Harlem, stewing it up here, expressing. Yes, yes, D-Cross. The artist. Shout out to my man, Brother Earl, and the whole crew that's up here. Peace.
Here at Red Lobster supporting DJ Blade. It's his birthday. I'm here every Monday night. Open mic, spoken word, here with Brother Earl. Come out and support. Come out and, just like you see me here with DJ Blade supporting him, I can do the same thing for you. Just reach out to me at 212-714-7188 or reach me on Facebook, Claudette St. Rose, or inbox me, Claudette St. Rose. Happy to come out and do the same thing that I'm doing here for him, celebrating his birthday. I can come out and celebrate yours or any event that you have. Just reach out to me, Claudette St. Rose. And I know that you could be doing something else, but I am happy that you're watching me. Thank you for watching me. Thank you for supporting me. And please reach out to me. I will be happy to come out to you. Maya, I love you. You're coming home soon. I know that I can be a little bit tough, but I do it only because I love you. And I just do what I do and say what I say because I care. Mom loves you. I love you. Everything that I say to you is because I lived a little bit longer than you have. So that's why I say what I say, because I have a little bit more experience than you do. I love you. I'll be back after these commercial breaks. Stay tuned. Continue to enjoy the show.
Yes, 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 y'all. This is Locksmith. I'm the inventor of this backpack. It's called a Leatherback Backpack. You could go on Instagram, leatherbacks_backpack. If you could turn around and model it for them. So it's modeled after the Leatherback Turtle. It's a flip-fold backpack and lounge. And it's something that I'm going to aspire to create for the general public. This is my prototype. And it's going to be something that's issued for everyone to be a part of. This is a carry-on. And again, it's a flip-fold backpack and lounge. Again, if you want to find me, it's on LBBP on YouTube. LBBP trailer on YouTube. You'll see the whole video of it. Or Instagram. That's leatherbacks_backpack. Thank you all. And this is D-Back, D-Black, the model right here. All right, thank you all.
Hey, what's good, y'all? This is comedian Tony Bird. Listen, man, my birthday comedy show this year is going to be in Brooklyn at Lindenwood Diner. Tickets was only $10, man. Come on out. I got new material. It's going to be bananas. I'm telling you, tickets are $10. The last Thursday of the year, come spend it with me, man. Share your, if you celebrating a birthday, get at me. You know what I'm saying? Because we can celebrate the birthday together, man. So listen, comedian Tony Bird, Tony with an I, Bird with a Y, man. My 51st birthday is going down December 28th. I need y'all in the building. Thank you.
Happy holidays from DJ Mario TV.
Peace and blessings, family. This is Brother Earl. We are right here live and direct at Freedom of Speech Open Mic, held each and every Monday right here at Red Lops on 125th Street. We here celebrating DJ Blade's birthday, having a good time. The artists are bananas, okay? You should be here one of these Mondays soon, okay? Diamond video, Red Lobster, Believe in Yourself video, DJ Blade, man, it's a conglomerate up in this joint. I am your host, the conductor, Brother Earl, okay? You can catch me on Facebook, you can get me on Instagram at The Real Brother Earl. Yes, The Real Brother Earl. Hope to see you soon. Love is love. Yeah.
Like a spot, the final blow is so low, still on the ground.
couldn't prepare myself for this fine cry.
Since I can't have that note.
Give it up for Ivy, y'all. Okay. She was a little nervous, but we gave her the kind of love she's supposed to get. It's all right. We got an open mic, okay? This is where we learn and get it together. All right? I got some cool peoples. My peoples in the house, T, you know I love you, like Cook Fool, Ebony, y'all, you know you're my peoples, man. Y'all laying in the cut, doing what y'all do, man. Get both of y'all on this mic. All right, where are we? Yo, this life, man, you ready, man? You got something, man? Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for this life.
What's up? How y'all doing tonight?
Hi.
Hi.
Make some noise if you're living this life.
Yeah.
You're living this life.
Yes.
Yeah. I woke up this morning, I wasn't living this life. I was fucked up. I was not being present. Because there's some emotional scars. I almost didn't make it out the house tonight. Or today. I actually got out this afternoon. So I decided to come over here and spit this piece because it's about scars and it's about healing. I had to write it because it was so real. I have to speak this. Let me tell you a story. Tell you how she made me feel. I'm so scarred. This pain, it runs so deep. You see, she used me and abused me, called me all kind of names you wouldn't believe. Then she'd accuse me of all kind of things I'd never done. You see, this was just her game. Now she was playing and it had just begun. It was the fact that she felt like she had no life. She felt trapped with all these kids, so I became her fun. She was beautiful, but her fear and her hate would never let her believe it. So this web she spun when she played with the magic, she let me see it. When she played with the fire, she told me to watch it too. She pulled me in close, like to almost make me feel love, like, come here boy, like maybe she might even give me a hug. No, just calling me a fool. Always calling me stupid, you're not like Lanky, that's my little brother. And to tell you quite frankly, she always made him feel so special and told me that I was nothing. But that was my little brother, I love him, so I didn't care about any of that, just let me feel something. So you see, I'm all fucked up inside and I need to vent this shit out. So this stage, all these emotions, this motherfucking rage, this microphone, these words, this page, this shit is my therapy. I swear to God, what I'm telling you right now makes me almost want to shed tears, kind of like a nigga needs some tissue. Now let me be the first to tell you I'm a little bipolar and a little schizophrenic from this shit. Yeah, I got some issues from all this shit. Now there was my father too, you see, he made me feel the rage of slavery and the white man's switch. Or the ascension cord, brown and orange, it didn't make a difference because you see, when that shit hit the skin, it broke just like a whip. But I loved him because he loved me and he treated me special. He told me all kinds of stories, he taught me to use my mind, he made me so mental. He said things to me like, boy, you're special for this life, you're my golden child. God's gonna bless you. Now you see, my mother, she hated that, and she worked real hard to change that fact. My father always telling me that I was something, and my mother telling me that I was nothing. You see, that went against all her rules. It was foul, it was out of bounds, because you see, she was the referee. And this was a game that she made up, so I had to continue to take the abuse for her therapy. And I still understand, because you see, when my mother was young, she was abused too by her mother who didn't love her or hug her and treated her like shit, kind of like the way she treats me. And I had to understand, I had to accept that this was my life. It was my reality. You see, when my mother was young, she was beautiful, she was gorgeous, she was thin. Then she had children. First she had one, then she had two, then she had three. That be me. Then she got fat, and well, she hated that. And that was my fault. Then she had child number four, and things got worse than before. Along came my sister Nikki, who also had it pretty rough. Like when my mother would do her hair, she'd actually say, I hate doing this shit, it's so damn tough. The hair's so damn hard, it's so damn nappy, your hair, just like your daddy's. You get your hair from your father's side of the family. It's not like Nays, she light her hair soft. My mother would say my grandmother was white and my other grandmother was Cherokee Indian, who was also light with long, soft hair. So what happened to you? I don't have a clue. How'd you get so black? She hated that fact. Now this meant to my mother that my sister Nikki was ugly because she always called the dog. But let me be the first to tell you she's beautiful, she's a lion. She's who I call when I need to bark. When this dog wants to bark. Now let me finish the story. Along came child number five, and well, my mother got kind of huge. And along with that came more self-loathing, more self-hatred, and way more abuse. So I need to let these emotions loose. Now let me hashtag into the story and tell you about Tiny. That was my babysitter, my mother's best friend. She told me that she was my fairy godmother. She'd run me baths, and then she'd take me to the attic, and she'd make me touch her. Now she would actually do things that my mother would never do and never did. She'd actually pull me in close, give me a hug, but just to suck on her tits. Then she'd push me down into her hairy crotch, well, you know, making me lick on her clitoris. And well, like anything you do it long enough, you get kind of good, and to be quite honest with you, I really liked it. It made me feel good, and I guess from her point of view, I understood, because she made me understand that it was all for her fucking pleasure. Sometimes she'd take my brother and I at the same time, and we'd play this game called Lick Up Her Treasure. Now, this happened to me for the first 2 years of my life, from like the age of 2 to 5, and I know you're looking at me wondering, how did I make it? How am I still alive? Well, I did. I survived. Now this, my friends, is the story of a sexually, physically, spiritually, and mentally abused kid who innocence got took, robbed by crooks. But this life is here today to tell you that this life is still standing. And this life is still strong. That, my friends, is my therapy song. Thank you.
Wow. Powerful. Powerful. Thank you for sharing that. All right, brother.
This is Frank the Cameraman wishing you a happy birthday from Frank the Cameraman and DJ Mario TV.
You flew over all the celebrities.
Oh,
I forgot to tell you,
you
got a princess.
I'll hold you together. You are a part of me. How can you be apart from me? Hope reborn as we connected, except healing from each other. Mend your ego before you go. Before you go back into a world that wants to send you back into a time when it was alright for you or I to hang from a tree, spoiled, rotten, dead. A world that beats on you like waves crash into the sand. So beat my drum, strong black man. Beat my drum, strong again, and we'll end with this. Your head, my bosom. Carrier of all your secrets. My breast, blessed to be the quarters where you find sacred rest. Okay.
This is really hurting me. I want to give you at least a chance to say something, but I just feel like she shut that shit down. Like, that is like, it's a risky, right? Yo.
So this first piece is called, again, Atomic Bomb. A bomb, a rush of fireworks popping out of me, streaming down my face as I hear the sudden bomb, atomic bomb. The act of failed suicide for the third time, as I heard what she said, depression, cancer, wishing dead, world hate, fucking fate, bomb, atomic bomb. The selfish act, how can one even think to jump in front of a car? No thoughts, put her in the motherfucking ER, bomb. Bring my phone up, spit it out like nothing. Rush thoughts, quick reactions, fire flaming under a fraction of time. Bomb, atomic bomb. These emotions, these confessions, wake up call. Mother, wake the fuck up, it's a wake up call. Gone or alive, you need to see that. I know it's hard, but you have to survive. I'm your daughter, I'm your strength, I'm your heart. You need to remember that nobody can ever tear us apart. Quit the drama, fight the tears. Mama dear, I'm always here. You're not the only one in pain, so suicide, please refrain. Bomb, atomic bomb. This affects me too. When you're gone, I wouldn't know what to do. Expiration date on your foot, so why shorten your time? Broken hearts, there'll be plenty. New York City's new crime. You know how I feel. I love you every second of each day. My hope and faith for you are too high for you to wash that away. Bomb, atomic bomb. I'm strong because of you. Your journey has always been hard. So keep fighting and you'll have that huge house with the yard. In the end, you're you and the decision is yours. I just prefer to see you and no doctor walking out of the doors. You can fight fate any day, but guarantee you will lose. So be wise in your decision and think as you choose. Bomb. Okay. Atomic bomb. So my next piece is called Sweet Sexy High. I wanted to lighten up a little bit. So I lay here on this red couch and listen to the baby go to sleep. And I hear the sounds of your everyday sound of movement that comes from a kitchen. Cabinets closing, dishes moving, water faucet running, the clashes of knives, forks, and spoons talking to cover the sex, the amazingly hot, sexy sex. And I'm already under Mary Jane's spell. Under the purple skies, and my inner hormones connect with my thoughts, and my fingers explore down to what makes me a woman, and play in my world of hot juices that is released from such a fruit. I hear the moans, the sound of man thighs and nutshells coming together with the sounds of her thighs, and the sound of two trees getting hit together when the wind forces them to. Music plays. Alternative rock music and more sounds of this moaning and clashing of spoons and talking, and then heavier rock for that moment where gravity takes you down and you have no way to slow down. And more moaning, and imagine lips being bit, hair being pulled, eyes rolling back to slower music, to slowing down for the cool down on the treadmill, to talking, to ending. And I smile. For I am happy. There are people who enjoy their lives after marriage, after a child, after it all. All hail Mary Jane. Thank you guys.
Yeah, oh my goodness. It is unfair when a sister do something even remotely erotic, man. Yo, that little personification piece right there about some Mary Jane was crazy. Give it up for Aria one more game. Yeah. And like she said, that was her first time on my mic, okay? So what I like to say at that moment
say
was
it, baby. Say it.
That virgin was
tired.
Yeah. This next sister I'ma call to the stage. When I first called her, she was out. You know, she had to go see the wizard right quick and get her courage. You know, she had to go get some heart. You know, she had to run up the yellow brick road, see the wizard. Okay, now she's ready to share with us, and it's a beautiful thing. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for Tati. Come on down, sis.
Okay, y'all, I'm gonna bring it back a little bit of old school.
All right, all right.
Make you rock in your chairs. Let's get this. Turn it up, let's go. Hey! Go,
She was like, where is he at?
Yo. She didn't want to stop it. She was just like, damn, I'll just keep going, go out in front for a second.
Tati had a flashback. She had a Soul Train Dancer flashback right then, yo. She was doing her thing. Okay. Give it up for Tati Romo again, y'all. Yo, you worked that, y'all. You worked that. And you were singing. Gotta love it. All right. This next cat, I'm gonna call to the stage. Make some noise for Ronald Herrera. Come on down. Come on, make some noise for Ronald Herrera.
Testing. How y'all guys doing? I'm Ron. I always like writing poems. I've been writing since I can remember. I remember in high school, I used to take down the notes my teacher wrote on the board and no one else will, but I will. And then it just like notes and notes and notes and notes. C notes, you know? I fly away. I never fade away. But I am lying, because I do fade away. When I sleep in path, I am the mass. I'm high at last. Arabic's ass has me dangling glass. Black Lives Matter. This is wrong, not ratter. How y'all like that? Sorry, I just be getting inner wheezy and he's just like, you know.
You know, I'm gonna get something for my book.
All right.
Happy holidays, everyone. This is Craig Allen, the 1/3 of the co-host of How You Living Radio. Check us out every Sunday, 9-11 p.m. I want to give a shout out to Brother Earl. Thank you for allowing, you know, my talent to come through, perform. You guys should come out every Monday, 6 to 11, Red Lobster on 125th Street.
You can find me on social media.
Oh, yes. You can find me on Instagram at BigPopularTees89 or Facebook Craig Allen. Like the page.
3, 2, let's go.
Okay. Tonight was open mic night at the Red Lobster on 125th Street between 7th and 8th, and our girl Tati, okay, or Boss Queen, okay, and she sang that damn thing, took us all the way back like she always do, and I enjoyed every moment of it.
Church.
Hey, New York, New York. Y'all ought to come down sometime on these Mondays. Listen, I had a ball. Mario, thanks for letting me know. Every time this goes on, you call me and let me know. Sometimes, this time, they made me come. And I'm so tired. But I had a ball. I had a ball. Bye.
Happy holidays.
Thank you. Happy holidays. For the TUP. For the TUP.
Since open mic, okay? Be a friend and tell a friend to tell a friend. This is what we do, okay? It's free admission. Some of the people that grace this stage is off the chain. Make some noise for everyone that rocked out. This is what we did every Monday, man. Some sort of machination of greatness, man. Be it singing, comedy, poetry, rapping. This is what it is, man. So I thank each and every one of you for coming out. You have no idea the energy and the good vibes that a positive open mic brings in the community. So I thank each and every one of you for being here. And God willing, I will be back here next Monday, and hopefully I'll see each and every one of you. All right? Let's make sure we give DJ Blaze some love, man, because he is here for you. Okay? All right? And where is my Kato, DJ Black Kato? He's working the camera today. We got Mac DJ Mario, man, on the video. I mean, this is a collaboration, man, of artists, like-minded. Claudette, where you at? Believe in Yourself video? Yes, I mean, it's just a collaboration of real folks, man. So I thank you, and we're gonna turn that off.
How do you enjoy the show?
The show was good. It was marvelous. A lot of talent. God bless them. So, you know, continue to do what they're doing.
Yeah, so definitely, yo. Come out. You got a lot of people out here. How'd you enjoy the show, Mama?
I enjoyed it to the extent of minimalism. It was the perfect show for me for the end of the night. And I tell you, y'all did a beautiful job. Your people did a beautiful job. And I wish them all the best and all the luck in their career, whatever they choose to do.
So come on now, Harlem, you know, show support the community. Shout out to DJ Mario TV and Brother Earl. See you guys next week. It's Craig Allen signing off.